the customers to get out of the way. Dang customers. But I wanted to show you this dang 100 right up here, ServSafe certification and the 100 service rating. They're doing little cotton candies. Okay, and they've got, look at all these deals. Cheeseburger, french fries, you name it. Fresh squeezed lemonade. Okay, and I'm gonna go in and show you some of that here in just a second. You see their whole setup, the red and yellow on the trailer pops nice. Then they've got these corner protectors to keep people from walking over it. There's their upcoming events for people that ain't on social media. And then check this out, weighted down pots to hold the canopy down in case it gets windy. And then another menu right here. And there's a view from a little further away, but I'm gonna take you inside and show you. Hey Terri, I'm live. Do you want to do a lemonade?
Sure, let's do a lemonade.
And this is Miss Terri, and she's got her hot dog and hamburger earrings on.
And a lemonade. Okay, so we just kind of put our little lemonade station just on this side in between, obviously, the grill top and
that's perfect.
Before I ever put a lemon on my food trailer, it gets washed at my commissary, and I really did a lot of research, and I know everybody does their lemons different, but for me, this is how it works, this is what I've researched. So I take and fill a sink up at the commissary, I put my lemons in there, and I have just a little bit of baking soda, I put in my water, I let them soak.
Baking soda, okay.
And I let them soak for a little while, and then I rinse them and scrub them, and then dry them.
Dang.
Dry.
Yeah. So it gets all the wax or pesticides or anything off.
Absolutely. That's what
perfect.
That's what I researched.
I like it. So. I like it.
And when I do my lemons, I don't cut them all the way through if I'm going to be doing a lot of them, because then I can just keep them together, and then I can pick them up and then pull them apart. And
we'll make this one real good because I want it.
You want this one? Okay.
Yeah, I want this one.
You got it.
So manual squeezer here, the easiest way to start in this business, and it's the old fashioned way. It's a perfect way. You got to weigh more than Terri to pull it down, but
I'm looking forward to eventually getting a pneumatic. I really like that, but right now it's just not in
more. It's just more equipment.
It's more equipment, and I don't know where I'd.
This works great.
So there's that. Of course.
Look at that. See, it catches her drips. One thing I've learned about Terri and Craig, everything is clean, neat, nice, neat, and they have a system for everything.
And I tried the simple syrup, but it doesn't seem to be sweet enough for my customer.
What you're doing, yeah.
I'm going to play with it again because I would like to kind of go back to it eventually.
I like the old-fashioned way. People see you put sugar, people see you put lemon and water.
I add just a little bit of water to dissolve it to start with. So I'm going
to... Water doesn't have to be cold. It's better if it's room temperature or even warm, and it will dissolve up.
Nice. It's really good. And my stuff's never on the floor. It's on the bottom shelf. And then this is lemonade ice only. I dedicated it.
Separate it.
My tape is getting a little...
So she separates her ice for her lemons or lemonade. Shake it up.
And then I'm gonna
add more water. That looks good. Now, are you doing any flavored lemonade, Terri?
Not right now, but I do have all the flavor. Not all. I have a lot of flavors that Jason suggested. So I just need to make them up. But right now,
just sticking with lemonade.
I'm just sticking with simple.
I like it. Well, you got enough going on.
That's how I feel right now. I have
Well, I noticed when I walked up all the cobblers.
Yes.
I'm like, holy cow.
Okay, hopefully that was...
It looks delicious.
A lot of times what I'll do, if we're not busy, I'll let the customer try it. And if they need more sugar, I'll just reach out and dump a little sugar in it for them.
Good. Look how good that looks. Lemons right in. Hey, Mr. Craig.
How you doing? Excuse me.
No problem. And as you do this next order, you care if we just watch for a minute?
When yeah, you're then, fine.
Okay, I don't want to get in the way.
You're not in the way. You're more than welcome.
Look at that.
Okay.
Pretty clear cup, so you can see what you got.
And I like to usually flip that lemon around, but I...
There you go. That was perfect timing.
Hey, how you doing?
Toasted buns.
He said that's a good lemonade.
Good. I like those toasted buns he's doing there. I like them toasted. I want to show inside here real quick. This is amazing. Little sandwich prep station. Everything nice and neat. It's got cobblers over here ready. There's that pulled pork coming. He's doing fries right now. Later, I'm going to share with you some videos that I've done with them, with a closed, not serving customers, so that you can see all the unique little ways they've done this so that it works out well. Like little tips on keeping the grease tray inside the griddle here, the grease tray up there, so when you're traveling or pulling. Craig, her husband here, built all this out and just made a fantastic place to work, even with three people. And now there's four in here, and it's efficient and works. And it's nice, cool. They've got the air handler going, so the wind's coming through the windows, so it's not too terribly hot here. All right, folks, I'm going to go. I love you. I'll have more later. And if I catch any vendors tonight at the Dave Matthews Band concert, I may interview them too. We'll talk to you later. Bye.